got to keep them going. Big wheel rolling, moving on. The white line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead. And the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever. Cause men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man. And a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
Up that helmet.
You just called a half an hour ago.
I'm gonna keep calling until I get him. Give me the chainsaw.
You know, what are you worried about?
$1,500 is what I'm worried about. Two unpaid loads is what I'm worried about. A job is
what I'm worried about.
You know, I'm the one behind in my payments. All you're behind in is socks. Should have checked to see if that phone was out of order.
Oh, if it was out of order, some other trucker would have reported it. Look, it's a busy place. Busy outfit.
You are very helpful. What are you so cheerful about anyway?
Oh, man, don't get on my case just because I'm cheerful. Cheer up. It's going to be a good day.
It better be. It just better be. Great way to run a business. Don?
Sonny?
Yeah.
Hi.
Works. Look at that. In, out, empty. Okay, let's go.
Where are we going?
To find a job.
Okay.
Going to a competitor, huh?
Listen, if he isn't around there to do business, I'm going to where somebody is that'll do business. I'll pick up my checks later.
You're going to break up a long relationship.
If I have to, yeah.
What's eating you?
The bank.
Oh. The bank.
Yeah. The bank.
Want to stop for fuel?
We just came out of New Mexico, remember?
Well, you gotta stop and get a permit sooner or later.
Let's get it later. It costs $31.50.
Yeah, well, you're the boss.
Hey, they really do the business here. How you doing?
Hi.
They busy in there?
Never stops.
Yeah? That's good.
How does he pay on advances?
Did you ever hear of 4%?
No, not till now.
That's twice as good as anything I ever heard of.
He's got it cornered, man.
Oh, yeah?
Does he know you?
Well, he will now.
Powers, New Orleans, is he paid? Yes, I'll accept. Sam, 500. Okay, you know the rate. Sorry about that.
Western Union, just a moment, please. Help you?
I'd like to see Mr. Powers.
He's not expecting you, I take it.
No, but I got a brand new three-axle conventional.
A couple of truckers here to see you.
Come on in.
Are you, Oh.
Bob Powers.
Sonny Pruitt. My partner, Will Chandler.
That's Mr. Richardson, Amalgamated.
How you doing? Mr. Powers, I got a brand new rig, empty, ready to go. I thought I'd just drop in, say hello. Maybe we could get some business going.
What brought you into town?
Dropped off a load of celery at Central Produce a couple hours ago.
Who booked it for you?
Driscoll and Son.
I see. You like to haul exempt?
We'll haul anything. Mr. Powers, I need a load, and it'll get there on time, no damage, no problems. I've gone over 350,000 miles without an accident.
There's nothing for you, Pruitt. Sorry.
Sorry? Those lights have been flashing on that phone ever since we walked in here. You must book 30 or 40 loads a day. What do you mean, sorry?
You got a smart partner.
Yeah.
I got all the truckers I need. They're waiting in line.
Yeah, thanks.
How come you're not working with Driscoll anymore?
We haven't been able to get in touch with him. It used to be a crack outfit.
Used to be is right.
Yeah, well, maybe some other time. Let's go.
He acts like we got the pox for crying out
loud.
He's
got it cornered, all right.
Do any good?
What's with him?
He don't like outsiders.
Man, every trucker's an outsider.
You guys working regular?
Pretty much. Terms ain't too hot, and we keep busy.
So is this the only store in town?
This is it.
Can you say one word about how it's going to turn into a good day, and I'll drop you in your truck?
Make you feel better, you were psychic, but it is going to be a
good... Hey!
Great town, some great town.
Anything missing?
I don't know. Hey, what about the change bag?
See?
Not such a bad town.
Where the hell have you been? I must have called you 20 times on the road. The phone's either busy or there's no answer.
How you doing, Sonny Pruitt?
We came by here. There's nobody here. What kind of a way is that to run a business?
Well, I guess I'm in and out. I guess when you were here, I was out getting dog food or something. How you been, man?
Oh, yeah. It's my partner, Will Chandler.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, how are you?
Well, at least your old man could have been here.
Sonny Pop died about 4 months ago.
Are you kidding?
I wish I was.
We dropped the cellar in. I need my check.
Sonny, business has been really bad.
Before you say anything, I think you ought to know that he's about ready to explode.
Well, I guess you know what's coming then.
Yeah, I don't care if you have to sell every stick of furniture in this place, refinance your car, your house. I don't care if you go without eating. I want my check.
Checks.
But that's not even your money. It's my money. You've been doing something with my money?
Look, this is a lousy way to see somebody for the first time in 5 years. But, Sonny, I swear, the money was put into a trust account. And the bank got all screwed up. I just can't get to it for a day or so.
I wired you. I tried to call you. You knew I was coming. You had plenty of time. I can't wait a day or two.
Tomorrow, then. I'll get it for you tomorrow.
Okay, one day. And then I want the best load you got out of here. I don't want to spend one more minute in this town than I have to.
You guys are going to hate me. Look, business has been so bad you wouldn't believe it.
What?
Powers has got more business than he can handle.
Yeah, we want to know why? That's my business. Powers used to work for Pop and me. We brought Powers into this business. We trained Powers in this business. And then when Pop died, he left and took all of our biggest clients with him.
He left... What were you doing while that was going on?
I was minding Pop's estate, his dogs and all. And I wasn't at the country club, I'll tell you that much.
You mean that in 4 months, Powers took all your business?
Yeah, all of it. You guys want a beer?
No.
You know a guy named Richardson? Was he one of your clients?
Yeah, Richardson was our biggest client. He and Pop used to race dogs together. How do you know him?
We met him over at Powers. Went over there when you weren't here.
Oh. Sonny, I don't blame you for going over to Powers.
John, I'm sorry about all this. I loved your dad. I've known you for a long time, but I got problems of my own. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, sure. You're really sore.
Yeah. He's not a bad guy.
Yeah, I remember that about him. I do.
Two from carry $100, do your own unloading. You make a lot of money off of that.
Boy 18 like to learn trucker's life. Work for meals only for 3 months, then small salary. I'll bet.
But he didn't hum in a cab.
But you didn't set the maxis, did you?
Yeah. Like hell. Said to wait here, so we wait here.
I don't see what they can do in 30 minutes.
They got 35 patrol cars in this town. You can't hide a rig like mine in a carport. Yeah. Yeah, it's Sonny Pruitt. Yeah, right. Thanks a lot. I don't want to spoil a secret for you.
Hey, this is coming out of your pocket.
I know that.
We don't have the budget for this.
Let's go. Yeah, he's a repossession artist. See what I mean?
Thing that's gonna spring that truck is money. You heard of money? I didn't heard it. I got the number off the lock and I had a key made.
Look, Candle, I got
Candell.
All right, Candell, I gotta have that truck. How can I pay you?
I pay you if I can't make a living.
Oh, this is one wise guy.
Listen, I gotta be a wise guy in my business. There's one other thing you ought to know, that somewhere under this desk, I've got an alarm button which goes to headquarters, which is just two blocks away, so no rough stuff, please.
How come you got a pickup order on my truck?
Bank in Los Angeles is how come.
I mailed the bank that check 3 weeks ago.
That payment was late the day you mailed it. Look. Behind in the payments, October, November, December. Well, how did I know? Mails are very irregular.
All right, what do I need? $1,500, right?
Well, if they get that check you mailed, the bank still needs $1,500. S. Candell gets 10% penalty fee, so $1,650 will clear it all up.
All right, I'll work something out. Now, let's make a deal.
I don't make deals.
Where are the clothes?
Oh, the clothes, sir. Yeah, all right. Let's see now.
That's right.
I took the liberty.
The evening clothes, please.
I took the liberty of putting the bag of change in the rabbit's foot in that one.
Thanks.
The rabbit's... Wait a minute. Sonny, you bought a rabbit's
foot? Never mind.
Did you hear that? My partner bought a rabbit's foot.
It's terrific. Really terrific. No wheels, no job, no money.
Can't even sleep in the rig.
Who can think that far ahead? Only you.
Hey, Pruitt, listen to me. Let's get one thing straight. It wasn't my fault.
We should have left the fence open. Maybe somebody would steal something.
Where are we going?
I don't know. We're just going. Will you cut that out? Don! My rig was attached for non-payment.
Look, I was just on the phone with my girl trying to raise some money.
Well, what about the money in the trust fund?
The trust officer's out of town.
Come on, you gotta get us off the hook.
Now, look, there's gotta be something.
Right.
Wait a minute. Come on outside.
Hey.
Sonny, meet Explosion.
What do I want to meet a dog for?
How much I owe you?
$1,500.
This dog is worth $1,500. That'll settle our debt.
Oh, come on. What do I want with a dog?
Sonny, you didn't hear me. I said this dog's worth $1,500.
So sell him and give me the cash.
No, I'll do better than that. I will give him over to you now, before the race.
What race?
This dog is running tonight in Greyhound Park.
You mean that scrawny thing is a racing greyhound?
Nice dog, Sonny.
No.
No what?
Are you nuts?
Sonny, this dog is worth money. You forget what that is? It could be a gourmet meal ticket,
oh,
Sonny.
Come on, what do we know about racing dogs?
Now look here. Third race, Explosion, number 6.
What kind of purses do these dogs get?
Oh, maybe $600-$700, plus if he wins, his price goes up, maybe you get $2,000.
I can feel it coming. I can feel it going in and twisting around
just
and start...
Let it happen and take it easy. You bought a rabbit's foot.
I found that rabbit's foot.
There you go. If you just let it happen, this could be the luckiest day of your life.
Well, now, here are the papers.
Well, look at this. See that 5-1 on the morning line?
Now, all you have to do to take possession, sign right there.
Oh, sign it.
I must be crazy. A race is tonight, right?
Yep, tonight. Look, you guys, I got a million things to do, so I gotta get going. I'll catch you later. Explosion, run for the man.
Hey, call us a taxi, will you? Well? You still think he's just a scrawny dog?
Yeah. What other choice have I got?
Greyhound Park.
Is that dog racing or does he have a seat in the stands?
Shut up and drive.
You know, if this isn't my lucky day, I'll drive back with some Denver to Dubuque. These pooches can really move. They can hit 70 miles an hour.
Yeah, but a horse can always pull a load.
You like this? Look at that. He likes it. Likes the corned beef.
If that dog messes in this cab, I can't face the driver.
Hey,
I'm
hey.
Bailing out. I don't care if it's in the middle of moving traffic.
Hey, well, you better watch what you're saying. This dog is a gentleman and very sensitive. Here you go.
Maybe we could sell him before the race.
He hears you. We're in a lot of trouble. Listen, you don't worry about a thing. You stick with me, and everything's going to be all right. I'll give you all the corned beef you want. Here you go.
We don't know the procedure.
We'll take care of it for you, and I'll take the dog now, too.
Thank you.
Oh, not at all, and good luck.
Beautiful dog.
Yeah. It's a good crowd. Should be a big purse.
It's Richardson.
Amalgamated. I know what that means.
At the break, it's 1, 3, 2, 4, 6, 8, 7, and 5. Into the clubhouse turn, it's 1, 4, and 2. Into the back stretch, it's 1, 4, 2, 3, 7, 8, 6, and 5. And into the final turn, it's 1, 2, and 4. Into the home stretch, it's 3, 2, and 1. The results of this evening's first race are now official. The winner, number 3, Terry's Lad. Running second, number 2, Oshkosh Supreme. And running third, number 1, Carlene. For this evening's third race, a grade 2 event to be run over the 5/16th mile course. Number 5, Chopsticks, 66 pounds. Number 6, Explosion, 68.5 pounds. And number 8, Raleigh's Ripper, 59 pounds.
Raleigh's Ripper?
Those are the Greyhounds.
Yeah, it's the guy we met this afternoon, Roland Richardson. It's got to be his store. Yeah, look, see? He's got better breeding than our dog.
Better breeding. 2 hours, you're already an expert.
Oh, well, you just relax and enjoy things. You know, you're about to become a big power in the dog world. It's 2 minutes to post time. I'm going to go put a deuce on the Explosion.
Are you kidding?
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Greyhounds are now entering the track for this evening's second race, the second half of the Daily Double. Ladies and gentlemen, the Greyhounds are now being placed into the starting box. Ladies and gentlemen, the Greyhounds are at the post.
Here comes the rabbit.
At the break, it's 4, 5, 7, 8, 3, 2, and 1.
Come on, Explosion!
Go, dog, go! Go middle of the pack.
I don't see him.
You don't? What do you mean you don't see him? No, I don't.
Frankie's on the far side of number 5.
Oh, well. I still don't see him.
No.
No.
And into the final turn in 5, 1, and 4.
What do you mean, though? He's got to be there.
Into the
Are you sure of that?
Sure, I'm sure.
3, 2, and 1.
Well, there's no number 6.
What do you mean there's no number 6?
There's got to
be
number 6.
A number 6.
Ladies and gentlemen, Greyhound number 6, Explosion, did not break the box. It's possible he dropped a muscle. Although he did not break the box, he is still considered a starter, and no refunds will be made.
Great. He dropped a muscle. Maybe somebody ought to go out there and pick it up.
That's all right. That's not what it means. Dogs drop muscles all the time. They race with drop muscles all the time.
But not ours, right? Not ours.
Excuse me. Are you the S. Pruitt that just bought that dog?
Yeah. You decided to get out of the trucking business and into dogs?
Don't say another word, Mr. Richards. I didn't have to go along with it.
You know, it's Don's fault, really.
Something you think you know somebody, turns out you don't know him at all.
Huh?
That guy really stiffed us.
Relax, something will work out.
I just figure 18 years behind that wheel. What have I got to show for it?
Nice day.
Yeah, it should be nice to have somebody to go home to.
You had a chance for that.
Oh, right.
That kind of stuff.
Right.
Want a cup of coffee?
Kinky dog, right? He's got some freaky quality you forgot to mention.
Sonny, I cannot explain it.
Well, you're a big help.
We don't have a rig. We don't have a contract. There's no assistant driving jobs available. As far as lease hauling goes, the bulletin board has nothing.
And that dog's got nothing, and Sonny Pruitt's got nothing. You know, it's pure and simple. You suckered us into taking a dog that don't know come here from Sikkim.
That says the dog's okay and he won't move.
Look, look. Take him out to see Bill Bishop. That old boy knows everything there is to know about dogs. He trains them, leases them, boards them. He's one of the principal suppliers of the dog track.
Will he buy them?
Oh, I doubt it after what happened.
You know, you're lucky they don't still have debtors' prisons. I'd have you in one faster than I can shift gears. I knew there was something fishy about this when I couldn't reach you on the phone.
I've had it with you guys. I gave you a good dog with a grand and a half. For all I know, the reason he didn't run is because of you.
What if his trainer says the dog's okay and he still won't move?
Mr. Bishop? You Mr. Bishop?
Hi. Yeah, I'm Bishop.
Sonny Pruitt.
Sonny, nice to know you.
Will Chandler.
Well, nice to know you.
We got this so-called racing dog that's got a problem. Don Driscoll said that maybe you could help us out.
Ah, is this Explosion?
Yeah.
Hey, are you crazy, huh? What happened to you, huh? I was there last night.
Vet says he's okay, but he just won't move.
Yeah, he looks all right to me. Hey, want to run a little? Would you like to run, huh? I bet you would. Let's take him out with the others, huh? See what happens.
All right.
Come on, boy. Yeah, we'll find out what's wrong. Come on, boy. All right, we're going to take you out. Close that door, will you, please?
Yeah.
Here, run him out with the others, will you? Attaboy. I'll get it. Wait a minute right here. Okay, let him go. Let him go, huh? Oh, boy. Come on. Come on. Come on. Hey. Go. Go, boy. Jimmy, bring him out, will you? Well, those greyhounds just love to run, and yours looks as good as the rest of them.
What kept them in the box?
That beats me. I don't know. Dogs are like people sometimes. You know, they act crazy, and then all of a sudden they recover. I don't know what happened. Let's put him on the whirligig over here and see what happens, huh?
Like that,
huh? He sure looks good to me. Well, what would you like me to do?
Sell him.
I don't think you'd get too many offers after what happened.
The racing form says that kennels will take a dog on lease and give the owners a percentage.
Yeah, well, I used to do that, but I'm only into 100% owned dogs now. Oh, besides, Explosion can't be raced again until he's reschooled.
Reschooled? What does that mean? We got to sink money in him?
No, he's just got to run a couple school races at the track to prove to the judges that he can behave himself. I never had a problem like this before. Kind of fascinates me. Tell you what. Why don't you leave him with me for a while, and I'll see what I can do. And then we can always work out something later.
You mean that, Lee? That'd
sure.
Be great.
Okay. Hi, Bill. Hey, Raleigh, how are you?
Fine.
Hey, I'd like to have you meet a couple of
friends. Yeah, we met.
Hello again.
Bill, I need some advice on a feed mix.
Sure thing, yeah.
Tell me, how did Don Driscoll ever talk you guys into buying that lemon?
What makes you think he's a lemon?
Well, I think he'll run again.
How? The wrong way? Or backwards?
Your dogs have had some great season.
Tell you what I'll do.
If by some miracle you can get that dog entered again, I've got $50 that says any dog I got in the same race will take him.
Make it 100, you got a deal, hotshot.
Okay, it's a bet. Yes, sir. I'd say that's about the best deal Don Driscoll ever made.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, nothing, nothing. I suppose Don is all right.
Then how come you left him? He said that you were his biggest shipper.
Yeah. Well, his operation just wasn't right for me. Look, Del, I'm in a hurry. Do you think I can upgrade performance by changing feed mix?
Oh, yeah. We'll see you later. If you need us, you can get in touch with us at the truck stop, okay?
Truck stop, right.
See you.
Nice see you later.
Well, somebody's working.
Yeah, look at all these guys.
Let's try the back room. Hey, guys, how you doing?
Did you guys line up anything?
Nope. Hey, you keep pretty busy, don't you?
Pretty much.
I'll tell you what, why don't you get two loads? I'll go with you, Sonny, go with you. We can use the bread, man. We're up against it. He just got repoed.
Might be able to do that. We could pick up some extra bucks.
We give it a shot.
Mr. Pruitt, telephone, please.
Right back.
Mr. Pruitt, telephone, please.
Yeah, this is Sonny Pruitt. Oh, hi, Bill. Yeah, fine. Hey, listen, did you find out what was wrong with him? Oh. Well, you think we ought to still go through with it? Well, yeah, we will. Yeah, fine. We'll wait for you here. Bill Bishop, he's going to come by and get us.
Okay. Sit down a second. I'll tell you something.
Go ahead, tell him.
Tell me what?
Since we last saw these two fellas, they've been to Okie City and back.
Wow, that's fast.
That's what I said.
It had to be fast. It was hot.
Powers hauls hot freight. It's about all he books. That's why he wouldn't use you.
Books everything hot with the business he's doing?
Powers do anything to get business.
Hey, man, hot freight's as common as bees around a hive.
He also takes kickbacks.
You mean the shippers are in on it with him?
How do you think he got it all wrapped up?
Powers gets rich on us, and his shippers get rich on payola.
Now I get it. That's why Don's out of business. He got torpedoed by that crook. That fares it.
Hey, forget it. It's on us.
Oh,
where are you going?
Gonna pay a little visit to Mr. Powers.
Keep us out of it.
I never saw you before.
Hey, you
in my
guys,
life.
Be careful. You don't know what you're up against.
Okay, buddy. Thanks a lot. Got enough problems without guys like this.
The ICC knows about this clown.
I hope they find out soon. Partners.
Hey!
Where's Powers?
He's not here.
Well, where is he?
He's out. All right, hold it. I got two witnesses in here that say you broke in and tried to roust us. You get the point?
Powers will find him.
Now what are you gonna do?
Powers' house, if I can find it. You got a dime?
Come on! We don't have much time.
Never mind. What's
up? You gotta be there to sign the dog in.
What do you mean? He's okay?
He was at the schooling races.
Sonny, we gotta go with this. Okay, we'll take care of Powers later.
Hey, baby, how are
you? Hang a ride at the corner, will you?
Any special reason?
Yeah. Look at that.
think that thing's for sale, you vultures. Go on, fly away.
Come on, let's go.
Later.
Yeah.
Hi, baby.
Hey, Don.
Yeah?
We were off base.
How do you mean?
See, you were sold down the river. Powers bought your clients. He was running hot freight. There's no way you could compete with that.
Payola. You know, I never could figure it. I thought I was just doing a lousy job.
Now you know.
Look, I'll take him inside while you sign him up.
You know, that dog might make a nice pet, huh?
Oh.
Why?
That's all. Bishop says that's all they know how to do is run. They just
you
run
guys all set? Stuff.
Yeah.
You got a table?
Nope. No, everything's reserved. It's going to be a big night.
Ooh, it's going to be a big purse. What's he in?
Second race, second position.
How much you got?
20.
Hey, I got 4.
Okay. Sonny?
Oh, I don't know.
30-1.
What the hell? Hey. That's all I got. I lost my rabbit's foot. Maybe that's a good sign.
Well, you still got your furry dice.
Good luck.
See you later.
Outside. I ought to break your neck.
What are you talking about?
You put my broker in bankruptcy. You won't give us work when you've got work. And your goons threaten me with a gun. That's what I'm talking about.
Well, it says you got trouble.
Yeah, I do.
What do you guys want anyway?
Don.
What's going on?
I think you ought to hear this.
Hear what?
Oh, how Mr. Powers has decided you should give your business back to Don.
How I ought to do what?
Now, you're going to miss the payola and the kickbacks, but you'll get the same good service that you always did.
What are these two raving about?
Mr. Powers seems to be a little tongue-tied. Maybe it's the shock of going straight that does that. So, Will, why don't you just explain to all of us in very simple terms that we'll all understand?
Well, that would be appropriate. Well, it was Mr. Powers' idea that it would be better if you give your business back to Don. Isn't that right, Mr. Powers? I mean, otherwise the ICC would fall down on him for hauling hard freight, and he could lose his license, pay a $5,000 fine for each violation, and go to jail for any combination of the above. So rather than face that, he decided that it would be simpler if you helped out Mr. Driscoll and gave him back his business. Isn't that right, Mr. Powers?
Yeah, that's right. Powers? Did you involve me in any of this?
No. But, we could. Yeah. I mean, what do you think the president of your company would think if he found out that you were getting payola?
What's that?
This is a contract stipulating what was just agreed to.
On a racing form?
Well, a contract is a contract.
Hey, come on, hurry up. We got a dog around.
Witness.
Oh, yeah. Gentlemen, we thank you.
The Greyhounds are now entering the track for this evening's second race. be run over the 5/16 mile course.
All right, here we go. Best seats in the house.
At least from here we can see the race.
You know, if he didn't come out of the box this time, I'm going in and pull him out.
25 to 1.
That means we're the only ones betting on him.
Oh, Courier, that's Richardson's dog.
All right, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Greyhounds are at the post.
Here we go, here we go. Here comes the rabbit.
Into the clubhouse turn. It's 1, 4, and 2. Into the back stretch. It's 1, 4, 3, 6, 5. Heading into the final turn. It's 6, 3, and 2. With the 4 moving up. Ladies and gentlemen, the judges have called a photo.
Come on, developer.
How did it look to you?
You ran a great race.
Ladies and gentlemen, the results of this evening's second race are now official. The winner number 2, Explosion.
Oh, my God! How do you like that? The shoes on.
Let's get a second. Go get a lot of money.
All right, huh? 495.
Hey, pretty good, huh?
Pretty good. Listen, you are a genius.
Oh, not me. It was a dog.
Yeah, you're terrific. What do I owe you for?
Oh, I don't know. I guess maybe $100 be all right for my time in a dog's boarding room, huh?
Well, take 2.
Hey, thanks. Hey, Bill, you ever figure out what happened?
Well, it must have had something to do with this weight. You know, he was a couple of pounds over that night. Hey, you didn't feed him, did you?
Sandwich.
No. Dog is never fed on a day he races.
No?
No, if you're going to feed the dog, he knows that he's not going to race. And he'll just lie around, take it easy, you know.
Dogs know that?
Well, this one did, huh?
No, he didn't.
There he is.
Hey, would you take him?
Hey, wait a minute. I gave him to you.
Yeah, well, I'm leasing him to you. When the checks are mine already, he's yours.
All right. That's the way you feel about it. Thank you.
Hey, what do you say we go and see Sam Candle and get our rig back?
I think that's a great idea.
Are you, Harmon?
Can I help it if I woke up cheerful?
What are you looking for?
Oh. That rabbit's foot that I found in Albuquerque and I never told you about because you're always putting me down about being superstitious.
Oh, yeah, that. Well, I figured it wasn't doing you any good, so, I borrowed it.
Well, why don't you just hang on to it for a while? Things seem to be going along just fine the way they are.